They come now.
Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. Jehovah, you are the Father. Your mercy endures forever and ever. Oh, praise His holy name. The God of Abraham, Isaac,
Jehovah,
you are the Father
of all.
Your mercy endures forever and ever. Oh, praise His holy name.
Praise His holy name,
my soul and spirit. Praise the Lord.
I will praise the Lord,
my soul and spirit.
Oh,
praise the Lord.
Let us praise the Lord,
my soul and spirit. Praise the Lord.
I will praise the Lord,
my soul and spirit.
I say,
praise the Lord.
We will praise the Lord,
my soul and spirit.
Let us praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Worthy to be praised,
my soul and spirit.
Mighty one in battle,
praise the Lord.
King of glory,
my soul and spirit.
Oh yes, Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise Him. Praise Him now.
My soul and spirit.
Praise
the Lord.
I will praise Thy God.
My soul and spirit. Praise the Lord.
Can you lift up your voice and give God praise this morning? Our Maker, our Creator, our Savior, our Redeemer, our yesterday, our today, our tomorrow, our God forever. Can you let Him know that you are grateful this morning for another brand new day, for the gift of life, for all that the Lord did on Monday, what He did yesterday, what He said to do today? Can you appreciate the Almighty God? Can you give Him praise? Can you give Him praise? Masuka la brondo kosanta limama. Zaleba babaka sheka leba sintalia. Raboto gabali maka santalia. Our God desires to be praised. Our God desires to be worshipped. What a marvelous God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. What a great God we serve. What a powerful God we serve. What an awesome God we serve. Brethren, reference His holy name this morning. Thank Him for every of His goodness towards you, His mercy towards you. Oh, His enabling grace in your life. Appreciate God for journey mercies. Appreciate God for good health. Appreciate God on behalf of every member of your household. Appreciate God for the work of your hand. Appreciate God for your businesses. Appreciate God for your career. Appreciate God for the church of God. Appreciate God for our nation. Let lift up our voice and just bless the Lord. Oh, Mariba Sunta Alibaba. Zelema kakuka pashentele. Riprundo kotoka shikale mama kasantale. Zale baba kaka baba kashentali. Lord, we are grateful. Thank you, mighty Father. In Jesus' most wonderful name, we have given thanks. You want to lift up your voice and say, Father, because your mercy endureth forever, because your mercy prevailed over judgment, I come before you this morning. Please have mercy on me. Can you go ahead and ask God for mercy this morning? Can you ask God for mercy this morning? Ask Him to show you mercy as you begin your day. Let God show you mercy. Let His goodness and mercy follow you everywhere you go, everything you do. That in His mercy He will hearken to your cry. In His mercy He will answer you expressly. In the name of Jesus. Pareboto gazanta le mama. Zale boto gazanta le mama kasanta le. Makuka pa le brakete gazanta le mama. Zabale boto gazanta le. Daddy, please have mercy. Lord, please have mercy. Lord, please have mercy. Lord, please have mercy. Thank you, mighty Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. I thought someone would say a better amen. Can you put your hands together for the Almighty God, for the grace He has given to you to be here this morning? Is that all you can do? Zechariah chapter 2, verse 5 this morning. Zechariah chapter 2, verse 5. For I see the Lord will be unto her a wall of fire round about, and will be the glory in the midst of her. You are that fellow, say a louder amen. If God say He will build a wall of fire round about you, it means no arrow of the enemy will be able to touch you. No bullet of the enemy will be able to touch you. No calamity, no tragedy will be able to come near you. And so you want to lift up your voice and lift up your two hands and say, Father, say, Father, be unto me and my household, be unto your church, a wall of fire, a wall of fire run about us. Can you go ahead and talk to the Almighty God? Say, for I said the Lord will be unto her a wall of fire run about, a wall of fire run about. Ask God to be a wall of fire run about you, that no arrow of the wicked, no bullet of the enemy, no enchantment, no divination, no sorcery, no witchcraft manipulation shall come near you, shall come near your dwelling. Ask the Lord to build a wall of fire round about you and your dwelling, round about you and your children. Let the Lord laminate you in His fire. Let the Almighty God laminate you in His fire. Masuka labate kashenta limama, make you untouchable. Ask the Lord to make you untouchable. Ask the Lord to make you untouchable to sickness, to diseases, to affliction, to evil arrows, parima santa limama. Kali babaka santale. Brother, can you pray for yourself? Can you pray for every member of your household that the Lord will build a wall of fire, a wall of fire, a wall of fire? In other words, the Lord will laminate you in His fire. Masuka le baba, mare kakaba le mama kasantali, ke kaba le mama kasantali, yekele boka santali. In Jesus mighty name, we have prayed. Lift up your two hands to heaven and say, Father. You can do better. Say, Father, in this second half of the year, build a wall of fire round about me and my household, that throughout this second half and beyond, I will not know evil and I will not see evil. Can you go ahead and touch the Almighty God? Can you touch the Almighty God that you will not know evil and you will not see evil? I will not know evil. I will not see evil. Hey, Marie Baba Kakuka, Zalegre Boska Tele Prande Kasantalia. Daddy, let me not know evil. Let me not see evil. Talk to the Almighty God. Kaka Baba Kasantalia. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. He said, and we be the glory in the midst of her. Lift up your two hands and say, Father. Say, Father, be my glory. And let me not know shame. And let me not be disgraced. Be the glory in the midst of my home. Be the glory in the midst of my family. Be the glory in your church. Oh, add a lot to be your glory, your glory, your glory, your glory. Let God envelop you with His glory, that He will terminate every shame. He will roll away every reproach. You will not be disgraced. Oh, He said, and we be the glory in the midst of her. The glory in the midst of her. The glory in the midst of her. Lord, let everyone see your glory upon my life. Lord, let everyone see your glory in your church. Lord, let everyone see your glory. See your glory. Masuka ba yekato kazandalia. Oh, mare baba kasanta. Bore mate kashente li mama. Sapali prani kapali mama shentali. Can you touch the Almighty God? Can you touch the Almighty God? Maze kale baku santale. Thank you, thank you, thank you. In Jesus' most wonderful name, we have prayed. Lift up your two hands to heaven and say, Father, in your name, I take authority
over this day.
And I decree that only your will be done in my life throughout today. Let your presence go with me everywhere I go. Let your presence go with me everything I do. Let your presence be with me in the mighty name of Jesus. Go ahead and begin to take authority over this day. Command your blessings, command help, command peace, command joy into this day. Oh, Marima Kasantalia, thank God that you refuse to weep and mourn today, that you not weep today, you not sorrow today. Masaka Lapaka Santalia, that help will be available for you today. God will order your footsteps aright today. Brethren, pray. Commit yourself into the hands of the Lord. Baremate Gashenta Libaba. Robote Gazinta Limama Kasantali. Kakaba Yakala Bote Gashenta. Rabote Gazantalia. Pray that whatever the enemy have planned against you today, whatever the enemy want to execute today, let God frustrate them. Begin to plead the blood of Jesus upon your body, soul, and spirit, upon every member of your household, upon the road you will ply today, upon the vehicle you will enter today. Plead the blood, plead the blood, plead the blood, plead the blood. Masuka ya Baba, zalekeponda labo shantali, kagabora mata kasantali, brumaska leboto kashenta. Rekakuka pa masuntelele boza pa la mate gashentali kore mama 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 kore mama 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 kore mama 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 karaba te gashenta and so shall it be in Jesus name. I thought someone say a better amen. And so mighty and everlasting Father, I want to say good morning. Loving God, we appreciate you. Thank you for Monday. Thank you for Tuesday. Thank you for another brand new day. Thank you for what you are set to do in our life today. Thank you for your presence that we abide with us. Thank you, oh God, for your presence that will go with us. Thank you, oh God, for you will see us through today. Daddy will lift up our voice throughout today, oh God, mighty and everlasting Father. Build a wall of fire round about us in the name of Jesus. The Lord will build a wall of fire round about your family in the name of Jesus. The Lord will laminate you and every member of your household in his fire in the name of Jesus. The arrow of the wicked will not touch you. Arrow of death will not touch you. Arrow of sorrow will not touch you. Arrow of demotion will not touch you. Arrow of backwardness will not touch you. Arrow of delay will not touch you. Arrow of lack will not touch you. Arrow of poverty will not touch you. Divinations will not touch you. In the mighty name of Jesus, all the days of your life, you will not know evil. You will not see evil. The Lord will be your glory. And he will terminate every shame in your life. He will roll away every of your reproach. You shall not be disgraced. And as you take authority over this day will bless you. This day will not work against you. Whatever the enemy has planned into this day, let God nullify them in the name of Jesus. I said throughout today, only the will of God will be done in your life in the name of Jesus. God will give you reason to rejoice today. God will give you reason to laugh today. God will give you reason to celebrate today. You will not end this day empty handed. Your portion in this day you will receive. I say your portion in this day you will receive. What God has planned for you this day, let God release to you in the name of Jesus. And I pray for you this second half of the year. Whatever it will take, whatever it will cost, it shall be far better than in the first half. Spiritually, it shall be better. Physically, it shall be better. Financially and materially, it shall be better. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And the people of God will say a louder and a better. Put your hands together for the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Is that all you can do? Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Amen and amen and amen. Lift up your right hand and say with me very quickly, the Lord is awesome and mighty in all his ways. He is the Lord of hosts. With him nothing is ever impossible. I will worship the Lord every day. And I worship the Lord forever. I declare and I confess concerning me and my household that as mountains surround Jerusalem, the Lord will build wall of fire round about us. I declare and I confess that the Lord will be unto me a wall of fire round about. I am fully secure and protected by the fire of the Lord. Therefore, no divination and enchantment shall prosper against me. No witchcraft and sorcery shall prevail over me. Every arrow of the wicked shall be roasted by fire, and every agent on assignment against me shall be paralyzed by fire. I declare and I confess that my house shall be flames of fire, and my house shall be too hot for the enemies to hibernate. Sickness and diseases shall be taken far away from me, and I will not know any form of affliction or infirmities. I declare and I proclaim that the Lord God is my glory, and he will forever envelop me in his glory. He will forever envelop me in his glory. Shame and reproach shall never be my portion, and all the days of my life the Lord shall move me from glory to glory, and I will not diminish in favor. I'll finish well, I'll finish strong. My ending shall be far better than my beginning. I'll not go to hell. I'll reign eternity, and I'll serve the Lord all the days of my life. In Jesus' name, amen. Can you go ahead and apply the Holy Ghost for 1 minute? My super labote gashenta limama. So brande kaka baba kashenta. Ramote gazanta li baba kashenta li. Kukapala brande kasunta li. Regere kasunta li mama. Kakaba shentele. Zobale mama kasanta li. Thank you, mighty Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. I thought someone would say a louder amen. All that you have declared this morning, I set myself in pastoral agreement with you that God will cause you to eat the fruit of your lips. I say you will eat the fruit of your lips. Your confession shall prevail over every satanic decree in the name of Jesus. I decree in that name that's above every other name, every of your confession will become testimony. And any power say they will not come to pass, let God destroy them. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Seven powerful amen. Two. Louder. Four. Five. Six. And special one. Put your hands together and celebrate. Hallelujah. Amen and amen and amen. And so shall it be in Jesus' name. Do I have your permission to pray for you this day in that name that's above every other name? May the Lord set to you on every side. You didn't hear me loud and clear. May the Almighty God set to you on every side. One more time for the last time. May the Lord set to you on every side. Amen and amen. Let's be seated in his presence as we open our Bible to the book of Ezekiel, chapter 37. Ezekiel, the book of prophet Ezekiel 37. We are talking about complete restoration, part 2. And I believe the last part for today. And let's see how God will help us. And we'll do some laying of hands. And God will glorify his name. Somebody will be restored. I am so confident about it that somebody will be restored. Who is that fellow here today? And it's not going to be ordinary restoration, because the hand of the Lord will come upon you. The Bible says in Ezekiel 37, we read from 1 to 14, the hand of the Lord was upon me and carried me out in the spirit of the Lord and set me down in the midst of the valley, which was full of bones. Which were full of what? Bones. And caused me to pass by them round about. Round where? Round about. And behold, there were very many in the open valley, and lo, they were very dry. And he said unto me, Son of man, can this bone live? And I answered, O Lord God, thou knowest. Again he said unto me, Prophesy unto these bones, and say unto them, O ye dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Your situation will hear the word of the Lord. Your condition will hear the word of the Lord. Your finances will hear the word of the Lord. Your businesses will hear the word of the Lord. Your marriage will hear the word of the Lord. Your body and your head will hear the word of the Lord. Amen. And he said unto me, Prophesy upon these bones, and say unto them, O ye dry bones, do what? Hear the word of the Lord. Thus saith the Lord God unto thee, unto these bones, Behold, I will cause bread to enter into you, and ye shall live. And I will lay sinews upon you, and will bring up flesh upon you, and cover you with skin, and put breath in you. And ye shall live, and ye shall know that I am the Lord. So I prophesy as I was commanded. And as I prophesied, there was a noise. And behold, a shaking. And the bones came together, bone to his bone. And when I beheld, lo, the sinews and the flesh came up upon them, and the skin covered them above. But there was no bread in them. Praise the Lord. Then said he unto me, Prophesy unto the wind, prophesy, son of man, and say to the wind, Thus saith the Lord God, Come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon this slain, that they may live. How somebody is following? So I prophesied as he commanded me, and the breath came into them, and they lived, and stood up upon their feet, an exceeding great army. What is the meaning of this? Then he said unto me, Son of man, these bones at the whole house of Israel. Behold, they say, Our bones are dried, and our hope is lost. We are cut off for our parts. Therefore, prophesy and say unto them, Thus saith the Lord God, Behold, O my people, I love God. Amen. Behold what? I will open your graves. Nobody said amen. And cause you to come up out of your graves, and bring you into the land of Israel. And ye shall know that I am the Lord when I have opened your graves, O my people, and brought you up out of your graves. Verse 14. and shall put my spirit in you, and ye shall live. I shall place you in your own land. Then shall ye know that I, the Lord, have spoken it and perform it, saith the Lord. Brethren, a fantastic illustration of complete restoration. This restoration covers both physical and spiritual. The Lord used the dry bones as a metaphor for God's people who had lost hope, who by their situation and their condition felt they are hopeless and there can never be restoration. And for God to prove himself that all things are complete in him, he said even the dry bones, they are complete. They will live again. Can I pray for you, sir? Every hopelessness in your life, my God will turn it around. Kalima toga baka toga zantalia. Lita bazunta balekaka. Whatever is it in your life that look impossible, in that name that is above every other name, the God of all possibility will make them possible. Beloved, we can see from the story here that God restored his people physically and spiritually. Physically, when the bones came together, bones to bones, and the sinew, meaning the flesh, came upon it. That is physical restoration. Amen? And they were restored spiritually when the breath of the Spirit came upon them. I am praying for you, sir. Spiritually today, you will be completely restored. Physically today, you will be completely restored. In the mighty name of Jesus. Beloved, when they were restored, they became a great army according to the Bible, meaning they were free of sickness, free of diseases. I am praying for somebody here, God will restore your health. I say, God will restore your health. And the Lord restored them materially. That same dry bone was restored materially. By the time God was explaining what the dry bone stood for, he said, I will bring them back to their land. Meaning what they have lost, their possession was given back to them. I am praying for you. Your restoration shall be complete. Because materially God will restore you. I say materially God will restore you. I say materially God will restore you. I don't know where you are and where you're supposed to be. God is taking from where you are to where you're supposed to be. I said the Almighty God is taking you from where you are to where you're supposed to be. That is complete restoration. The restoration that covers both physical, spiritual, and material is a complete restoration. Lift up your two hands to heaven and say, my Father, my Father, my Father. Oh, you can do better. Let me also know complete restoration. Physically restore my body, spiritually restore me, material and financially restore me. Can you go ahead and touch the Almighty God? I don't know what you have lost. I don't know how hopeless your case is. Masupa la bonde la bo, shibrande gaga, kukapa nelele. So lama shiantale, kukaba le gazuta. Bora mate gaga, masondololo gizintalia, bramakuta gashentalia. Tota, complete restoration. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Be seated in his presence. Beloved, our God is awesome. And that's why, in the story of the dry bone, he used an extreme case to show you that your own case can never be worse than that. Is anyone here whose case is worse than what we are mentioning? I don't think so. And yesterday we told us that for complete restoration is a process. And that process will be completed today. And we told us yesterday that first thing that will happen is that you will be remembered. Amen? Amen? And I like it or not, God remembered the valley of the dry bone. That's why his hand came upon his servant and he took him to the bone, to the valley. And he made it to pass by all the bones. Praise the Lord. Your businesses will be remembered. Your finances will be remembered. Your marriage will be remembered. Your destiny will be remembered. If you are traveling there, your enemy will be louder than your neighbor. Then not only were they remembered, God visited the bones. God visited the valley. Hello? God did what? We told you that yesterday, that when God wants to restore you, he pays you a visit. I pray for you. You shall be visited. I say you shall be visited. I say you shall be visited. And you know what? In the case of this dry bone, God did not visit alone. He visited with his prophet. He took his prophet along. He said, come, let's go on an excursion. Praise the Lord.
Can I pray for you, sir?
God will visit you with your helper. I said, the Almighty God will visit you with your helper. One more time. King of glory will visit you with your enablers, with your destiny helpers. In the mighty name of Jesus. If you are saying amen, say loud and clear. And we told us yesterday that when God wants to complete the process of restoration, he will speak the word. Hello? And he spoke his word through his servant. He said, can they live? He said, you know, Lord. He said, professor. He spoke. He said, professor. He gave him the key. He gave him the strategy. Praise the Lord. And when he spoke, the result came. This morning, you also, you will prophesy. And your prophecy will not be in vain. And you know what? I want you to know that God has not changed. For the Bible says, he calleth in that are not as though they do what? They were. Brethren, everything God has made have ears and they can hear. Including this microphone that I'm holding. It has ears. The ground has ears. The air has ears. Can you imagine? Even dry bone that you can say, oh, it's a dead thing. It's not living thing. Am I correct? We believe that it is only living things that can hear. Am I correct? But as far as God is concerned, both living and non-living things hear his voice. Dry bone is a non-living thing. Am I correct? Then he said to his servant, prophesy to the dry bones. Hello. After he prophesied upon the bones, and the Bible said, bone to bone, they came together. Amen, somebody? He now moving further and say, oh yeah, prophesy upon the wind. Prophesy to the wind. Brethren, you are going to prophesy to your finances. You didn't get that one. Let me tell you something now. You will not believe me. Do you know you can prophesy money to come and money will come? Do you have that faith? Money have years. You can prophesy your helper to come and they will come. All things have ears. You can prophesy to the ground to open and the ground will open. You can prophesy to the ground to bless and favor you. The ground will bless and favor you. Amen? Let me also shock you now. Do you know the chair you are sitting upon? You can prophesy to it. Oh my God. How many of you believe what I'm saying? The chair you are sitting upon, you can do what? What kind of prophecy can you prophesy? Oh, share. Walk in my favor. And as I sit upon you, let my healing come. And you don't discover that share will work for your healing. Oh, my God. Sir, man, all things God have created have and can. Others have years. That's why I told his servant, prophesy against the altar, I bet. So you can use your tongue. All you need is that let the Spirit of God be you. Praise the Lord. I say, praise the Lord. I say, praise the Lord. I say, praise the Lord. Then the Bible says, the prophet prophesy. The prophet does what? When God is behind a prophet, whatever he says will come to pass. That's why in 1 Samuel chapter 3 verse 19, God did not allow the word of Samuel to fall to the ground. Praise the Lord. Your own word will not fall to the ground. I say your own word will not fall to the ground. In 2 Kings chapter 7, when Elijah said, by this time tomorrow, by this time tomorrow, the Lord did not allow his word to fall to the ground. Your own word will not fall to the ground. If you are saying amen, say it loud and clear. I say, if you are saying amen, say it loud and clear. One more time, if you are saying amen, say it loud and clear. And then the Bible says there was noise. There was what? Sama. When restoration comes, there will be shout of rejoicing. There will be what? When the bones came together, the Bible said there was noise. In your home, there will be shout of rejoicing. There will be shout of celebration. I said there will be shout of celebration. I said there will be shout of celebration. I said there will be shout of celebration. In the mighty name of Jesus. Beloved, on that fateful day, the wind blew. Hello? And there was spiritual restoration. Dry bone became a living being. I am praying for you. Anything you have lost spiritually, God will renew in the name of Jesus. I say the Almighty God will renew in the name of Jesus. And the good news is this. When God restores, he restores back your greatness. And so the Bible says, it was a great army. It was what? A great army. Can I pray for you, sir? Whatever that have tampered with your greatness, God Almighty will restore it today. I say God Almighty will restore it today. I say God Almighty will restore it today. In the mighty name of Jesus. Brethren, there is nothing like spiritual revival. That's why in Psalm 85 verse 6, Psalm 85, it says, "Wilt thou not revive us again, that thy people may rejoice in thee? Wilt thou not revive us again, that thy people may rejoice in thee?" Brethren, when God revive you, when God restore you, you rejoice. And today, you will rejoice. I said, today, you will rejoice. I said, today, you will rejoice. Which area do you want your restoration? The hour has come. It's going to be a complete one. I said it's going to be a complete one. In the mighty name of Jesus, shall we rise? Because of what we want to do. I see the glory of the Lord descending in this place to bless us one more time. I see the glory descending in this place
to bless us one more time.
You are the first to lay your hand on yourself.
Lift up your two hands and lay it upon your head. Because there is power in your hand also. And as you lay those two hands on your head, Can you go ahead and begin to prophesy into your life? Can you prophesy into your life what you want to see? The kind of restoration you want to see. Oh, Marima Teka Santa Limama. Zaleka Kuka Paramatoka Shanta Limama. Zalika Kaprando Koto Gazintalia. Brother, prophesy, prophesy. Don't keep quiet. Prophesy long life. Prophesy peace. Prophesy joy. Prophesy breakthrough. Prophesy blessings. Spiritual blessings. Natural blessings. Material blessings. Marima Teka Sheta Limama. Prophesy your healing. Prophesy good health. Prophesy victory. Oh, Marima Baka Santa Limama. Zaleka Barobotoga Shenta Limama. Rakakutaga Sandalia. Brother, say something to your life. 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 Prophesy that you will make it. Prophesy that you will succeed. Prophesy that you will excel. Prophesy that you will prosper. Prophesy that you will be great. Prophesy you will not go to hell. Prophesy you will serve God. Prophesy anointing upon your life. Masupa la prade kasantalia. Prophesy joy. Kale prado kusapala. Marikakaya. Prophesy total restoration. Complete restoration. Kalima kakuka. Ye pale kade kakakaka. Gazanta limama. Kurema santa limama kasanta. Jele kasunta limama. Bale mama kasanta. Kalibra de kasanta. Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Beloved, we want to do the laying of hands. All you need to do is to zero your mind, the area you need restoration. And I'm believing God this morning that in that name that is above every other name, your restoration will be a complete one. And from today, your testimony will start. In the name of Jesus. Can we begin to worship the Lord? Can we worship the Lord? Haka Hakaya. Haka Jehovah Nimema. We just file out like this, ushers. Honorable. Recover everyone in the blood of Jesus. Yes, Lord.
Jehovah, Touch me, Lord.
Touch me one
now touch me, Lord.
Touch me one more time, oh Lord.
Jesus, touch me, Lord.
Touch me one more time, oh Lord.
Savior, touch me, Lord.
Touch me one more time, oh Lord.
Father, touch me, Lord. Touch me, Lord.
Touch me one more time, oh Lord.
I say, touch me, Lord.
Touch me one more time, oh Lord.
I say, touch me, Lord.
Touch me one more time, oh Lord.
Jesus, touch me, Lord.
Touch me one more time, oh Lord.
I say, touch me, Father.
Touch me one more time, oh Lord.
Jesus, touch me, touch me.
Touch me one more time, oh Lord.
I say, touch me, Lord.
Touch me one more time, oh Lord.
I say, touch me, Lord.
Touch me one more time, oh Lord.
Jesus, touch me, Lord.
Touch me one more time, oh Lord.
I say, touch me, Lord.
Touch me one more time, oh Lord.
Jesus, touch me, Lord.
Touch me one more time, oh Lord.
I say, touch me, Lord.
Touch me one more time, oh Lord.
Can you stretch out your hand to the altar? Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Kalima to Gazantalia. Rema Santo Basi Kaleprando Kasanta. From the crown of your head to the tips of your toe, be filled in the name of Jesus. Spiritually, let the Almighty God restore you fully in the name of Jesus. I prophesy into your life, you will not toil again in the name of Jesus. I prophesy help for you in the name of Jesus. I prophesy favor upon your life in the name of Jesus. Let God restore your finances. Let God restore you materially. Let God restore your marriages. I prophesy before the end of this year, you will possess your possession. I prophesy long life upon your life. I decree you will not know untimely death. You will not know premature death. In the mighty name of Jesus, every satanic implantation in your body, get out in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Blessed be the name of Jesus. For we pray in Jesus' name. I just want to say that amen three powerful times. Lift up your offering once again and say, Father, my finances, lost opportunities, lost businesses, I use this seed as a point of contact. Restore back fully. Go ahead and talk to the Almighty God. Kalima to Gabrende Kasuntali. And so shall it be. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Can you say that? Amen. Three powerful times. I want to go. Put your hands together for Jesus. Is that all you can do? By the special grace of God, because we are talking about complete in Him. Tomorrow, we're looking at complete joy. What do I call it? Somebody's joy will be full. Yeah. You are that fellow. Let your hallelujah be the loudest. And our evening program continue tomorrow and continue this evening. The time is 5 to 6. Come and let us pray under the same corporate anointing. And I know your testimony will come. Can I ask you, whose testimony will be the biggest? You believe your own shout the loudest, hallelujah. The grace.